80. rocznicę powstania Muzeum Polskiego w Ameryce. Jego historyczne i kulturalne skarby, jego rolę w Polonii amerykańskiej oraz ludzi, którzy udostępnili tę możliwość, aby przeszłość zachować dla przyszłości. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Today we celebrate the 80th anniversary of the Polish Museum of America, its historic and cultural treasures, its role in the Polish-American community, and the people who made it possible. It is here where the past is preserved for the future. Wśród miłośników Muzeum Polskiego w Ameryce znajduje się kadra archiwistów, która w dalszym ciągu dba i rozwija nasz historyczny amerykański dom Poloniny. This museum is the family home of America's Polonia, and the staff of archivists who continue to care and cultivate its treasures are among the most dedicated. It is my pleasure to introduce the managing director, deemed the 2016 Dziennik Związkowy Person of the Year, the incomparable Małgorzata Kot.
Dobry wieczór. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for those kind words. I will have to check the treasurer to find out what that does truly mean, but I do appreciate this wonderful gesture. It's a very important moment right now at the Polish Museum. We were advertising the whole event of beginning the year of Jubilee of the Polish Museum. And we said that on January 12, 1937, we had the chance to do a marvelous, wonderful photograph. And right now we have a historical moment as well. Julita Sigio, our photograph curator, is right there. Everybody who will be in the picture will be preserved for the future generations in the same style we did it 80 years ago.
Drodzy Państwo, ponieważ mieliśmy okazję robić zdjęcie pamiątkowe 12 stycznia 1937 roku, chcemy tę sytuację powtórzyć. Prosimy wszystkich, którzy są na zapleczu, wszystkich naszych wolontariuszy, aby znaleźli się w tym momencie w objęciu, jak gdyby, obiektywu. You need to join us, all of us, all of you. Julita will take the photo. Drodzy Państwo, zapraszamy, abyście byli tutaj z nami. Ci, którzy nie siedzą, aby się ustawili. I spojrzymy za chwileczkę w górę. Drodzy Państwo, w tym momencie, jak przychodzicie, mogę też powiedzieć, że mamy ze sobą dzisiaj Krysa Biele. Krys Biele jest twórcą świetnej prezentacji dla, która się nazywa Urbanik, i w tym momencie właśnie robi wspaniałe zdjęcie time-lapse, czyli w tym się też pojawimy. So Krys Biele is taking a time-lapse from the other angle, but we wanted to immortalize this moment. I will be in silence, I will take my seat. We will have two options and run standing. Wow, standing ovation. We had the chance to be in the historical photo. Together we find ourselves on the 80th anniversary of the formal opening of the Polish Museum of America. I have had the privilege to develop as a professional and work alongside many talented co-workers for half of my life and over a quarter of the PMA's rich history. Stoimy dzisiaj w świetle rocznicy 80-lecia uroczystego otwarcia Muzeum Polskiego w Ameryce. To 8 dekad przebogatych w historię i przebogatych doświadczeń naszej załogi, w szeregach której miałam zaszczyt pracować i rozwijać się przez połowę mojego życia. In September, President Richard Owsiany and I had the opportunity to meet Minister of Culture and National Heritage Piotr Gliński and accept Gloria Artis.
Gold Medal of Merit to Culture on behalf of the entire Polish Museum of America. This visit to New York, and we have guests from New York today, is also very symbolic, as so much of the city relates to our collection. I recalled all the people who were involved in creating the Polish Museum of America, and I'm more than happy to have the entire row of closest family to Sabina Feliksa Logisz, whose this particular great hall is named after. And we were able to remember PMA's founding and all those who engaged throughout the community and their difficult efforts in acquisitions and cataloging and their standing with Polish American people and American Polonia as representatives of the mission of the PMA. Miałam przyjemność odwiedzić Nowy Jork, to co powiedziałam przed chwilą. To był bardzo ważny moment, dlatego że w jednej chwili wspomnieliśmy wszystkich tych, którzy stworzyli Muzeum Polskie. Wspominając tych, z którym dane nam było się poznać. Wymieniłam rodzinę pani Sabiny Feliksy Logisz, z którą współpracowałam przez wiele lat. I w tym momencie chcę zapamiętać tych, którzy współpracują z nami codziennie, w trudzie, w znoju, jako wolontariusze. Ci, którzy poświęcają nam bardzo dużo czasu. Praktycznie każda z tych ścian była dotknięta przez jednego bardzo miłego człowieka, przez pana Zenona Żmudę, który odszedł wczoraj o 4 rano do pana. Był bardzo miłym człowiekiem, był zawsze pięknym w sercu, pomagał nam przy każdej czynności. Jest symbolem dla mnie tej dzisiejszej uroczystości. Tych osób, które bez żadnego słowa pomagają na każdym kroku. Yesterday one of our dear colleagues and co-workers, Mr. Zenon Żmuda, passed away at 4 a.m. And he's a symbolic for this particular event of many of those who are with no, even a talk, even a word, are helping every day and helping us to develop, helping us to grow. We sincerely thank all of our volunteers for their immense contributions and assistance in so many projects. We thank the Consulate General of the Republic of Poland and the Ministries of Poland for all the support extended to us. And most of all, we thank Polish Roman Catholic Union of America for founding us, being our major supporter, a friend, and a colleague in every single day of their lives. Dziękujemy wszystkim tym, którzy nas wspierają, tych, którzy nam pomagają, konsulatowi generalnemu, dzięki któremu otrzymujemy nagrody z Polski, najrozmaitsze granty, ale przede wszystkim Zjednoczeniu Polskiemu Rzymskokatolickiemu, w którym budynku się znajdujemy i którzy pomagają nam na każdym kroku. 2017 will be a jubilee year surrounding the PMA's 80th anniversary. Join us for the Pulaski Day, for the summer ball, for many events, for the wonderful concert that we'll have about Chopin, for anything, because that's your place. Polish Museum is ours. Ten rok jest rokiem jubileuszowym. Cały rok. Zapraszamy Państwa na obchody Dnia Pulaskiego, na naszą główną imprezę dochodową, bal letni, ale przede wszystkim zapraszamy też na to, abyście Państwo znaleźli czas, żeby przyjść do Muzeum Polskiego w normalny dzień, być z nami, być naszymi członkami i czuć, że to jest także Wasze, drodzy Państwo, miejsce. I would like to wish you a wonderful, joyous and very museum new year. Życzę tego wszystkiego Państwu, aby ten rok był naszym wspólnym rokiem. Dziękuję serdecznie za Wasze wsparcie.
Equally important in the operation of the Polish Museum of America is the leadership of the Board of the Directors. Bardzo ważne w funkcjonowaniu Muzeum Polskiego jest kierownictwo zarządu. Jesteśmy szczęśliwi, że muzeum ma kolejnego, rzetelnego i solidnego lidera. As in the past, the museum is fortunate to have strong leadership. President Richard of Chane has stepped up to the task, and now I ask him to step up to the podium.
Thank you. Good evening, and welcome to the 80th celebration, anniversary celebration of the opening of the Polish Museum of America. It's fitting, you know, that you reflect on 80 years and look back at our beginnings, and you look back at the people who had the foresight, who had the determination to come up with a place where our heritage can be brought into one place. The gentleman who I look at as being critical in the formation of the Polish Museum is President Józef Kania. In 1935, after many attempts during the conventions at the PRCUA of bringing a resolution and getting the PRCUA to start and fund a museum, President Kania in 1935 was able to do that. And in doing that, he planted the seed of what we see today. He also had the foresight to bring on board our first curator, Mieczysław Hyman. Between President Kania and Mieczysław Hyman, they began acquiring what you see here today. Now, the museum, when it first opened, was one little room, which today houses the Paderewski collection. But over the course of the next 30 to 40 years, the collections and the acquisitions grew and grew and grew, that the PRCUA knew that in order for the museum to sustain and be viable for the future, it needed a place much bigger than the little room where today the Paderewski collection is housed. And through the Polish Roman Catholic Union, they allowed the museum to expand, and today the fruits of that expansion are here in this room, in many rooms throughout the PRCUA. But I think the real story here is that the museum is a story. It's a story of us. It's a story of Poles, a story of Polish Americans. It tells of what we have accomplished. It tells of our glories. It tells of our disappointments. It tells of our thorough grasp of our heritage. And that continues for 80 years. It's very pleasing to know that throughout these 80 years, we've had people who have supported the museum, who have contributed financially, who have contributed the times. You know, we have a staff that's passionate, and that's the key element of our existence. It's the passion that the staff brings to the Polish Museum of America. Our biggest obstacle back in 1935, as is today, is finances and being able to fund and support the museum. Over the years, we've had tremendous support from many, many people. And that support over 80 years has gotten us to where we're at today. But today, we also rely on many individuals, our memberships, our small donors. But there are individuals that I like to recognize this evening who make it possible for us to do the work that we do. I'd like to recognize Dr. Helena Preston-Szedatek, an individual who came to the museum, came to our library, and became enthralled. When Dr. Przydatek passed away several years ago, she named the PMA in her will, and she bequeathed a substantial amount of money to the PMA, which allows us to do our work. Other individuals who allow us to do our work include, we have board members who go beyond their duty, and one of our board members goes beyond the call of duty, and that's Stephen Kuzmiaczek, along with his wife Jamie. We thank them for all their financial support that they give us. Other organizations that help us include the Edward Puach Foundation, the I.J. Roman Foundation, the Legion of Young Polish Women, who have been with us from practically their existence in 1939, and who are probably there one of our biggest supporters. And of course, the Polish Roman Catholic Union of America. There would be no Polish Museum of America if it wasn't for the Polish Roman Catholic Union of America. The foresight that the founders of this museum, who were the leaders of the PRCUA, had to have a place where our story can be told. And we have a lot of people who don't wish to be known. We also have a lot of people who don't wish to have their names mentioned. You know, to all those people, we also acknowledge them and thank them publicly. A lot of people think that the Polish Museum of America is only Chicago-based. It is not. We have support throughout this country. And I am honored this evening that one of our biggest financial supporters over the last several years came in from Texas to be here tonight, and that's Deborah Greenlee, sitting right here. So where do we go? What's the future? Folks, ladies and gentlemen, the future is dependent on us. Not the workers, not the volunteers, not the board, not the members, but all of us collectively as members, donors, supporters. We've made it through 80 years, and in 80 years, we've kept to our mission, preserving the past to benefit the future. In doing so, we've also created a treasure of Polonia that is not only for our use, but more importantly, so that Americans can see what we as Poles have accomplished and what we as Poles have in us to keep preserved for that future. Szanowni Państwo, dziękuję za przybycie dzisiaj do muzeum na nasze 80-lecie. Przez te 80 lat nasz muzeum działa i działa, ażeby ubezpieczyć nasze dziedzictwo. Bez państwa to jest niemożliwe. Dzisiaj sam fakt, że ponad 200 osób jest obecni na nasze 80-lecie, mówi dużo o nasz muzeum. I podkreślam, to jest nasz, wszystkich, którzy tutaj są, członkowie, sponsorzy. Bardzo ważne, że to jest nasz muzeum. I jest ważne, że żeby przetrwać przez następne 80 lat, czy następne 100 lat, wasze poparcie jest konieczne. I polegamy na to, ażeby ten muzeum był skarbem Polonii. Dziękuję.
Rzeczypospolitej Polski w Chicago, a Muzeum Polskim w Ameryce jest nie tylko ważna, ale i niezbędna. Rezultatem tego związku jest patriotyczna, finansowa i kulturalna pomoc. There is no doubt that the cooperation between the Consulate General of the Republic of Poland in Chicago and the Polish Museum of America is not only important, it is essential and has resulted in patriotic, financial and cultural support. Szanowni Państwo, Konsul Generalny Konsulatu Generalnego Rzeczypospolitej Polski w Chicago, pan Piotr Janicki.
Let me start from saying, always like coming here. All the events are bilingual, so even if you lost in translation, you will always know what's going on. Bardzo lubię tu przychodzić. Wszystkie te okoliczności, w jakich tutaj byłem, zawsze wszystkie te święta były obchodzone dwujęzycznie, więc niezależnie od tego, czy mówicie po polsku, czy po angielsku, czy w jednym i drugim języku, zawsze możemy w pełni uczestniczyć w tych wydarzeniach. Więc zacznę może po polsku, a potem sparafrazuję po angielsku. Dziękuję za zaproszenie przede wszystkim. Dla mnie to ogromny zaszczyt móc tutaj być. Jestem tutaj już po raz który, nie wiem, już nie liczę, bo pomimo tego, że jestem tu od 6 miesięcy, to bywałem tu już wielokrotnie i zawsze przychodzę tutaj z wielką radością, bo to, tak jak już było tutaj mówione, miejsce specjalne na mapie polonijnej. I muszę powiedzieć, że niezwykle się ucieszyłem, kiedy się dowiedziałem w zeszłym roku, że właśnie muzeum będzie uhonorowane w ten szczególny sposób, że to muzeum zostanie przysłany i wręczony medal Benemerito, medal Ministerstwa Kultury i Dziedzictwa Narodowego, który został odebrany w Nowym Jorku. I cieszę się z tego, że w ten chociażby tylko symboliczny sposób, ale ważny sposób to miejsce zostało uhonorowane, bo na to w pełni zasługuje. To miejsce, gdzie przechowywane są skarby naszej kultury. To miejsce, gdzie można zawsze przyjść i dowiedzieć się coś ważnego. To też miejsce, do którego przybywają ludzie z Polski, żeby robić badania naukowe. Właśnie w zeszłym roku gościliśmy w konsulacie jednego badacza, który pisał książkę na temat Paderewskiego i właśnie tutaj w Chicago szukał swoich dokumentów do swojej pracy. Ladies and gentlemen, it is always a pleasure to be here. I've been here multiple times. I don't remember exactly how many times, but it's always good to be here. And I'm always welcome here, and everyone is welcome here. This is a place of a great people. This is a place where people come here and they always find something interesting to learn about Poland. Not long ago, I had a visitor from Poland, and he was doing research because he was writing a book about Paderewski. He came here all the way from Poland to do the research because you have such a valuable things here in this museum. I'm always honored to be here. And not long ago, the representatives of this museum received the Benemerito from the Ministry of Culture and Heritage. This is a symbolic gesture, but it shows how deeply appreciate this place and the people who work here is. As a Polish consul, I'm very humbled, and I would like to congratulate you on everything you did and will do in the future within that 80 years. And please, be very supportive, not only with your hearts. Open up your hearts to this place, but also open up your wallets. It is very important. Thank you very much, and I wish you a pleasant evening.
As its founder, the Polish Roman Catholic Union of America holds the museum near and dear to its heart and continues to stand in support of its mission together with other contributors. It is a part of the PRCUA legacy. Założone przez Zjednoczenie Polskie Rzymskokatolickie w Ameryce, Muzeum Polski jest częścią jego spuścizny. Zjednoczenie dalej go wspiera razem z wieloma innymi fundatorami. President of the Polish Roman Catholic Union of America and the Chairman of the PMA Board of Directors, Joseph A. Drobot Jr.
In keeping with the bilingual messages that have been expressed this afternoon, and as part of, some of you know, my attempt to recover and recapture my Polish language that I learned from many, many years ago, I have prepared a message to read to you in Polish. Wish me luck. Witam wszystkie serdecznie. 12 stycznia 1937 roku pod kierunkiem Zjednoczenia Polskiego Rzymskokatolickiego w Ameryce. Muzeum Polskie w Ameryce otworzyło swoje drzwi po raz pierwszy. Było to wielkie wyrażenie dla polskiej kultury i polskiego dziedzictwa z Chicago, jak i w całym Stanach Zjednoczonych. Minęło 80 lat od tego wydarzenia. Pragnę pogratulować dyrekcji muzeum, pracownikom i wolontariuszom za poświęcenie i niepierwaną pracę w rozwój tej placówki. Niech magia tego miejsca. Nie maga tego miejsca. Będzie inspiracją dla wszystkich do poznawania polskiej historii i kultury. Dziękuję. Teraz będę mówił po angielsku. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm so thrilled that you are here to celebrate with us this great, great event of 80 years of collections of Polish culture, history, memorabilia, and archives. This building is magic. You can come to this building and stand in front of the salt sculpture from Wieliczka and be transcended to a mining operation that goes back many, many centuries. Or you can stand in the back of the room and look up at the Stations of the Cross that were a gift to the museum from the first settlement of Polish immigrants in Panna Maria, Texas. Polish immigrants in Texas. Or you can visit the Paderewski room and see history right there in front of you with the creation of the Polish nation after so many years of captivity. You can look at the mosaic of the young Polish maiden, 21 years of freedom, holding the sheaf of wheat to feed the nation and the sword to protect the nation. All of that is here. You cannot get it all in one afternoon, but it is here. It was a gift to us from the people of the past. But with that gift also comes a very great responsibility. It's our responsibility to protect this for the future. If you can, when you can, help the museum, we definitely would appreciate any effort on your part. We must protect this, preserve it, and promote it for future generations. In closing, I would like very much to congratulate the directors of the Polish Museum of America, the employees of the Polish Museum of America, and especially those volunteers. Thank you so very, very much. Enjoy the rest of the afternoon.
It is only fitting that before I introduce the next number, I bring to your attention the fact that each and every one of you is an honored guest. We did not specify certain guests, but I must tell you, 80 years, that's a long time. But I know somebody in the audience that has that beat. Ladies and gentlemen, a friend of mine who has celebrated 3 days ago her 100th birthday, who is an author, who is an ethnographer, who is a choreographer, who has actually found the fountain of youth in Polish folk dancing. Never forget that the Krakowiak is alive and well and better than any aerobics you could ever sign up for at a health club. Szanowni Państwo, dzisiaj uhonorujemy panią Adę Dziewanowską, choreografem, etnografem, autorem. Pani Ada, bardzo proszę, żeby wszyscy wstali i zaśpiewali 200 lat! 200 lat! I 200 lat! Jeszcze raz, jeszcze, jeszcze.
I will try to oblige at least 200 years. So see you soon.
I bet you didn't see that coming. Kto tańcuje, a nie umie, tego Pan Bóg wyrozumie. Kto tańcuje, a nie śpiwo, na tego się Pan Bóg gniewa. And now, as a tribute to the Polish folk costumes in the museum's possessions, a short suite of dances from Old Warsaw, performed by one of the couples from the Wesoły Lud Polish Folk Dance Company of the Polish Roman Catholic Union of America, who is celebrating its 40th anniversary this year. Artistic director and choreographer, Richard Jamiński.
Trójmity, 30 płyty, 7-5 słuchowisko dla dzieci, 8-4 jakaś płyta, 8-9 ktoś coś czyta, to nieważne, najważniejsze dziś jest ona. 1, 7, 3, 5 ktoś mi wszystko dziś poplątał, ale jedno wiem, umówiłem się z nią na dziecko, na dziecko, no już. Zaraz wezmę od szefa akonto z kupińskich róż. Potem wino, cukiernia i spacer, księżycową jasną noc. I będziemy szczęśliwi, weseli, aż przyjdzie północ i nas podzieli. I umówię się z nią na dziewiątą. Na dziewiątą, tak jak dziś.
Close to the time period of when the museum came about. so. Also, I wanted to mention that we have other royalty. As I said, you are all treasured guests of ours, but I want to point out that we have a young royal couple here, the Cinderella and Prince Charming from the Adult Culture Group, Kayla Leonhard and Kasper Kaczmarczyk. It is important for our young people to know their heritage. I want to say Kayla, for example, is 50% Polish and the other is American Indian, Irish, Scottish and German. So you need to embrace your whole heritage. Thank you for coming today. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we received many well wishes, many greetings from many different people. And one very important one is a resolution from the state of Illinois. I would like to introduce Daniel Pozhogelski, who represents State Representative Martwick.
Witam Państwu. Sam poseł chciał tutaj przybyć. On jest jako jeden z niewielu Amerykanów polskiego pochodzenia, który reprezentuje nas i naszą społeczność w Springfield. Ale jego nieobecność jest jak najbardziej usprawiedliwiona, bo dzisiaj są chrzciny jego syna. Więc teraz po angielsku. My name is Dan Pokrzyżowski. I work in the office of State Representative Robert Martwick. The representative wanted to be here today, but his absence is, one could say, without any exception, totally okay. Why? Today is the baptism of his firstborn son. Thanks to Representative Martwick, I have an official resolution by the lower house of the state legislature, and to spare you all, I'll only read the beginning of it. Whereas the members of the Illinois House of Representatives wish to recognize the Polish Museum of America, one of the oldest ethnic museums in the United States, and whereas in 1931, a fire destroyed the Polish Library and National Museum at Alliance College in Cambridge Springs, Pennsylvania, and the Polish American community began looking for a new venue in the United States that would promote both Polish culture and history and the Polish presence in North America. Whereas the Polish Museum of America was established in 1935 and officially opened its doors on January 12, 1937 as the Museum and Archives of the Polish Roman Catholic Union of America. May it be resolved that by the House of Representatives of the 99th General Assembly of the State of Illinois, that we recognize the Polish Museum of America and we wish them many more successful years. And be it further resolved that a suitable copy of this resolution be presented to the Polish Museum of America as a symbol of our respect and esteem. I also have here an official certificate that Senator Omar Aquino has given to the Polish Museum from the office of the Senate President, and just wanted to make sure that both of these would be in the rightful place here at the museum.
I was very impressed with Consul Janicki's command of the English language, but I think it's amazing, but I am very impressed with the command of the Polish language by those who were born here in the United States. Mr. Drobot, A plus, not because you're my boss, but I'm very impressed with you. But also that young man, Mr. Ovshany, we're all giving it our shot. We're going to try as best as we can to keep up with your English. How's that, Consul? Our next speaker is a lady that needs no introduction, the recipient of many awards for her tireless efforts on behalf of the Polish Museum of America and the Legion of Young Polish Women. But for the Polish Museum of America, for 10 years, she served as president, and the last, because that wasn't enough, she also was the treasurer. Szanowni Państwo, wielokrotnie odznaczoną za pracę dla Polskiego Muzeum mam zaszczyt przedstawić byłą prezeskę Polskiego Muzeum, panią Marię Cieślę.
Thank you, Misha. Dziękuję. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Dobry wieczór, szanowni państwo. It's always such a pleasure to return to the Polish Museum of America. I have great excitement whenever I come back in the building, which isn't too often right now, because my husband and I are very busy in our retirement with our grandchildren. The 80th anniversary is symbolized by oak, and we know what an oak tree is and does. It is very slow growing, very majestic, and very beautiful and full. And so it's appropriate that the museum is celebrating its oak anniversary. And I congratulate the wonderful staff, the board of directors, the volunteers, and all who contribute to the Polish Museum of America. Debbie, it's so good to see you here. It means so much to us for your kindness and generosity. Thank you. I have the honor to present to you the most recent class of the Heritage and the Legacy Life members of the Polish Museum of America, a program that was started by Joanne Ozuk, who is in our audience today. Thank you, Joanne, for all your tireless work. Some of our current class could not be here this evening, but we will still recognize them. And at the end, I would like them to stay and also for a photo. And I will also ask all of the Heritage and Legacy and Millennium Life members to please stand. So without further ado, it is my privilege to present first the Heritage Life, the newest Heritage Life members. We have five. That was a program that was started about 2007 for a $10,000 donation and up. Rosalie Lindberg is not able to be here this evening, but she took a Heritage Life member in October of 2015 in memory of her beloved husband, Raymond Lindberg. Rosalie is from Park Ridge, Illinois. She was an early Millennium Life member who chose to become a Heritage Life member. So we salute Rosalie very much, and hopefully everything is well. We will begin with the first Legacy Life membership. You see their name here on this wall. You see them everywhere. They have had their competitions, their dictandos here at the museum, and we're very happy, and they've been very supportive all the years as institutional members. But in June of 2015, the Polish Teachers Association in America of Chicago, Illinois, became Legacy Life members under the presidency of Pani Ewa Koch. I know that some of the directors are here, so would you please come forward from the Polish Teachers Association in America? They are very modest, very modest. If you will permit me, I will read the actual inscription. Life Member Recognition, the Polish Museum of America, presented to the Polish Teachers Association in America of Chicago, Illinois, for your contribution as a Legacy Life Member donor as of June 2015 to the Polish Museum of America. Your interests in and support of the oldest ethnic museum in America, where the past is preserved for the future, is greatly appreciated. Certified on this day, January 2017, Richard Ofshani, President, Joseph A. Drobot, Jr., Chairman of the Board. Congratulations for the work that you do. Thank you.
tak.
Ale to jest nasz stary uczeń.
Jest taki start. Nie.
Już?
Razem razy.
Dziękujemy.
Gratulacje jeszcze raz. Ale pani zostanie na tym.
In January of 2014, Małgorzata Pałka and Daniel Sobel became Legacy Life members in memory of Małgorzata's daughter, who was tragically killed by a bus just a year or two before this. So Małgorzata has become a wonderful volunteer, and Daniel is always with her whenever he can be here, and we love them both very much. So Daniel and Małgorzata, would you please come forward? They took out individual life memberships.
They're on their way from Cancun.
Oh,
their son got,
gosh.
Their son, you know, is getting engaged, and they will be here because they promised. So
okay.
I'm sure that they will introduce
okay.
them.
Okay, very good. We will applaud them at the time. The Polish American Congress Charitable Foundation became Legacy Life members under President Virginia Sikora in August of 2014. They are from Chicago, Illinois. I do not believe there is a representative here this evening, but if there is, we would love to have you come forward. Well, we thank you and we salute the Charitable Foundation. The next three Legacy Life members were purchased by their father. These are a brother and two sisters. The father and mother and the children originally lived in Grand Rapids, Michigan. Mr. and Mrs. Lewandowski have been very good supporters of all the major activities of the Polish Museum of America, its summer ball, the heritage, the membership evening. So none of the children are able to be here, but beginning with the son, Luke and Marissa Lewandowski became Legacy Life members in January 2015. They live in Chicago, Illinois. At that same time, Libby Lewandowski Wilhelm and her husband Peter became Legacy Life members because of her parents. They also live in Chicago. And the last one was Sophie Lewandowski, who became a Legacy Life member in January 2016. Sophie also lives in Chicago. We should give their parents and them a round of applause. Marek and Agnieszka Kowalczyk, who are the owners and founders of IDEA Furniture, became Legacy Life members in June 2016. They live in Park Ridge, Illinois, a great suburb. And I'm not sure, they were on their way possibly? Okay, another couple that is on their way. Lovely couple, Marek serves on the board of directors now of the Polish Museum, and Agnieszka is very much beside him. So we thank them for their wonderful contributions. And whenever Art for Heart is held here, which if none of you have been for the Art for Heart, you should come because it's an amazing week. And the Kowalczyks have always donated for that period of time the furniture, which makes people comfortable as they sit around after looking at all the wonderful artwork and jewelry and sculptures that are here. Okay, so we'll congratulate them. We will go on to newer life members, Rita Rose and Thomas Alvin Mauerman, who became life members in July 2016, and they are from Duesman, Wisconsin, and they were not able to be with us, but we're very grateful for their life membership, so we need to applaud them. And our last Legacy Life member is a young man that I have never met, but who started out with a bang at the museum with very large donations, yearly large donations, and they finally got him as a life member. So I'm very happy. And he is Jeffrey R. Pakula, who became a life member in December of 2016, and he lives in Chicago. And I don't believe that Jeffrey was able to make it, so we will applaud him. Yes, you may.
Ladies and gentlemen, you know, the program of life members and our heritage members is vital to sustain the operations of the museum. And we received Magorata and I received some wonderful news 2 days ago that the Polish Educational and Cultural Foundation of Orlando, Florida is winding down their operations. But they were wondering what to do with their treasury. Well, they will take out a Heritage Life membership and the remaining funds donate to the museum. They won't win this class, but we wanted to make the announcement that our support reaches out beyond Chicago. We have Texas with Deborah Greenlee, and now we have Florida, and these are people who come and support the museum. So we'll be announcing our next event. They'll be honored, but we wanted to make sure that you knew that their support of the PMA came in just 2 days ago, and we're thrilled that we are able to announce that to you this evening. Thank you.
That is good news indeed. And on this, what I would call Paderewski Hyman Logish weekend, because it's a good weekend, a beautiful weekend for January, we all need to celebrate the museum. And in doing so, I would like to ask all the Life members and Heritage Life members present to please stand so we can salute you. You know, it's a lovely group, but it needs to be larger. So please consider taking out a Legacy Life membership or even Heritage Life membership. Thank you. It was wonderful to be up here again. Thank you. Have a wonderful evening.
The Secretary of the PMA Board of Directors is Victoria Granatsky, who has authored many architectural and community histories for Chicago and its suburbs, and prepared nominations for listing a wide array of residential, commercial, and industrial buildings on the National Register of Historic Places. This building that we are in today, built in 1913, houses the national headquarters of the PRCUA, as well as the Polish Museum of America, and the library, and all that. It was listed on the National Register of Historic Places on January 2, 2013 by Ms. Granatsky. She is also the author of Chicago's Polish Downtown. Ms. Granatsky brings her expertise to us this afternoon.
Good evening, everyone. We've had the pleasure of sitting in this room for the last hour or so amidst many of the treasures that this museum has. But it is my assignment this evening to let you see some of the historic images and pictures of things that perhaps you're less familiar with, as well as to share with you some of the treasures that we have that are hidden in other parts of the museum that are not always accessible in our archives and our library and in many of our collections. So as soon as we get this presentation set up, let me know when. I have a hard time seeing this here. Okay. Well, as we know today, we're celebrating the Polish Museum as one of the oldest ethnic museums in Chicago. Founded in 1935 by the Polish Roman Catholic Union of America and the presidency of Joseph Kania, who was mentioned earlier and is illustrated on the right. And the museum is dedicated to preserving the artistic, cultural, historic, and literary heritage of Poles and Polish Americans. The Polish Museum and Archives officially opened on January 12, 1937, in the three reconstructed offices on the second floor, now housing the Paderewski collection. And they held this dedication ceremony, which was in the room that we're sitting in. Mieczysław Hyman was the first curator, archivist, and librarian. And he was ably assisted by Sabina Logish, after whom the hall here, the Great Hall, has been named. He supervised the acquisition of books, documents, photographs, and artifacts which came from all over the country. The PMA today serves three major functions, which I think it's important to remember. It's not only the museum with the permanent and special exhibits that most of you are probably very familiar with, but it's also the historical archive and a library that's open to all researchers. The Great Hall of Exhibits opened in 1939, just 2 years after the original rooms opened up downstairs, and features the museum's permanent collection. A commanding presence on the stage, which you've been looking at prior to us pulling the screen down, is the huge painting of General Kazimierz Pułaski, who was mortally wounded at the Battle of Savannah in the U.S. Revolutionary War. At the close of the 1939 World's Fair in New York, many of the exhibits from the Polish Pavilion, which include paintings, sculptures, crafted items, and a very large stained glass window, which I know you've seen in the back of the hall here, could not be returned to Poland with the outbreak of World War II in Europe. So the museum was fortunate to receive and be able to display many of them in 1941. Precious artifacts in the Great Hall include the royal sleigh of Princess Maria Leszczyńska, who would become the wife of France's King Louis XV, and the Stations of the Cross, which are across the former balcony in the back of the room, also mentioned earlier, from Panna Maria in Texas. The Paderewski Room contains the largest collection of memorabilia anywhere, representing the career of this Polish pianist, humanitarian, and World War II statesman, Ignacy Paderewski. Maybe many may not know this, performed at the opening of Chicago's 1893 World's Columbian Exposition. The room downstairs was completely redesigned and renovated with a grand reopening in 2010. A ladies' auxiliary of the Polish Museum organized the art gallery in 1973 and the mezzanine. The nucleus of the collection were items from the art room in the 1939 New York Fair. Some of which are illustrated here. It reopened as the Stephen and Elizabeth Ann Kuzmierczyk Art Gallery in 2011 after an extensive renovation of the space, including state-of-the-art security, lighting, and climate control. There's a diverse poster collection of over 5,000 posters from the end of the 19th to the 21st centuries, and 900 of these are showcased in a catalog entitled Art of Association, Modern Polish Posters by Monica Nowak. The PMA Archives has over 300 collections at almost 1,000 cubic feet, representing individuals, organizations, associations, and other notables in the Polish-American community. There are documents from kings, including one written in Latin on parchment, illustrated here by Zygmunt II August, King of Poland, and it's sealed with wax and dated in 1555. Other precious documents in the collection are letters from former President Thomas Jefferson, Revolutionary War General Pułaski, President Abraham Lincoln, and Polish King Gustav III. This map of Lublin, Civitates Orbis Terrarum Lublin, is the oldest map in the PMA collection. And this illustration here is a woodcut print that was published in 1493. The PMA Photographic Archive has an estimated 25,000 photographs and negatives depicting the rich history and diverse aspects of the lives of Polish immigrants in the United States. The majority of this collection dates from the beginning of the 20th century through the present and contains black and white and color prints and negatives. This image here was recently restored. It's an impressive panorama from 1908 depicting the dedication of St. Stanislaus Kostka School. Also recently restored, and actually right around the corner by the buffet, is this photograph and collage of renowned Chicago opera singer Rosa Kielbasa Kwasi Grosz, which shows her portrait framed within a large lira instrument and surrounded by actual butterflies and beetles and dried plants. Among the other historic photos are these two, one of actress Helena Modjeyevska, who played Camille at the Chicago Opera House in May of 1887, and Ignacian Paderewski at Warsaw's Saski Garden in 1890. The PMA Library is open daily for readers, researchers, and genealogists, averaging between 400 to 500 visitors monthly. Over 56,000 titles are available in Polish in a wide range of topics, and in English on Polish subject matter. Cataloging is underway, as you can see in the lower right slide, using the Mac Plus online library database system, which follows the standards of both the National Library in Poland and the U.S. Library of Congress. The PMA's oldest book was published in 1508. It is a textbook on composing Latin verses written for students at Krakow Academy, which later became Jagiellonian University. The top illustration is from a popular textbook on oratory from 1512, and the lower illustration is from 1745. So you can see the incredible extent of the historic collections in the library. Kronika Polska from 1597 shows a detail of King Jagiello. And also here on the right is the smallest book in the PMA Library collection, which is a miniature poetry anthology. The Polish Museum is the official site of the State of Illinois Pulaski Day celebration, the first Monday in March. You can see some of the photos from prior celebrations here. Typically, the mayor and elected state, county, and city officials are in attendance before an audience representing major Polish organizations. It will be held this year in March, and there'll be information, and we urge everyone to attend this. We also have various exhibits, literary discussions, lectures on art history, film screenings, and musical performances that are mounted throughout the year. There are quarterly workshops for children and families on Polish holiday traditions such as Easter, palm weaving, and egg dyeing, Wycinanki, Kite Day, and Christmas ornaments. And I have to say, I couldn't resist putting my granddaughter in the slide on the lower right side, who is having dinner tonight without me, so I could be here. Go ahead. In addition to the renovation of the Paderewski Room and the Kuzmierczyk Art Gallery, a prominent new entrance for the PMA on Augusta Boulevard had its grand opening in January 2014. It features a new lobby, a gift shop, a conference room, and additional modern office space. Yes, that's the slides of the lobby and the entrance. Go ahead. The Helena Przybyszewska Rare Documents Room opened in 2015 to house and safeguard the oldest and rarest PMA items in a climate-controlled state-of-art space. And you can see those, they're bookshelves that are on a track and can slide back and forth. And of course, you can compare to the situation before we were able to put in this exceptional storage room. The archives room opened on the fourth floor this year, and we'll soon be moving books into that, providing much needed space. Polish Past in Chicago from 1850 to 1939 is a permanent exhibit of Polish immigration to Chicago that opened last year with funding from Poland's Ministry of Culture and has plans to travel to other cities. The Rare Book Conservation Project aims to professionally conserve 300 rare books printed before 1870. And shown here in stages of conservation is Vitae Regum Apollinarum, written by Klemens Janicki in about 1543, and featuring short biographies of Polish kings and dukes. The photographic digitization project was initiated in 2005 using a past perfect database and is now online to facilitate worldwide access to the PMA collection. When you have some time, I urge you to go on and just stroll through the photographs. It's quite fascinating. To date, over 5,000 images have been cataloged and scanned. So as you can see, besides our ongoing programs, we have had a number of accomplishments related to both our physical plant and to our collections. But moving into our 81st year, we still have more plans to upgrade our physical space. Renovation of the Great Hall here would restore the stage, which you can see has been closed in some years ago, address circulation problems, and reconfigure some of our display spaces. Our glorious stained glass window, the symbol of Poland Reborn, is sagging and needs to be repaired. And there are backroom areas of the museum that are also in need of cleaning and refinishing. Go ahead. To engage a wider audience in the artistic and cultural heritage of Poland and Polish Americans, the permanent collection would be reorganized and remounted. Age has taken its toll, and grants from the Polish government and private foundations are being used to conserve some of those in greatest need, and we are looking for funds to continually restore the entire collection. The PMA remains today the United States' preeminent cultural institution dedicated to collecting, preserving, interpreting, and presenting the history of Poles in America and the world. It sits proudly in its 1913 PRCUA building, now listed on the National Register of Historic Places. These two institutions stand today as beacons in Chicago's Polish downtown, a lasting reminder of the historic origins of Chicago's Polonia, which dominated this neighborhood, centered at Division, Ashland, and Milwaukee Avenues, well into the mid-20th century. Thank you.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, I could try to find different words to express what you're about to see next. But let's be honest. We have seen the past, we are here in the present, and the best voices are those of the future. And now, on behalf of the Tatra Mountain Cultural Foundation, their children will make a presentation and say a few words and tug at our hearts. Szanowni Państwo, najlepszy przykład jest przekazać to, co mamy następnym pokoleniom. I Fundacja Kultury Tatrzańska właśnie ze swoimi dzieciaczkami pokaże nam, co to jest ta przyszłość. Bo za 80 lat oni będą siedzieć tam, gdzie wy jesteście i oni będą bić brawo i myśleć o nas. Niektórzy będziecie, ja nic nie mówię, pani obiecała już 200 lat, to dla was niektórych to będziecie mieli 150 albo 110, co to jest. Ale najważniejsze są dzieci Tatra Mountain Cultural Foundation.
Polskiego imię nigdy nie zaginie, ani na Wiersycku, ani na Dolinie. To wersy nowej góralskiej śpiewki. Wincujemy i dziękujemy za waszą robotę, za to, że niesiecie radość i nadzieję, bo nasze bogactwo to honor, godna robota, wychowanie dzieci, nowych pokoleń, wierze ojców naszych i pielęgnowanie tradycji. Życzymy siły, wytrwałości i jeszcze większego zapału do krzewienia polskości na tej amerykańskiej ziemi. Pobłogosław Boże z tego wysokiego nieba, co by w naszym muzeum nie zabrakło chleba. Nie zabrakło chleba, dudki ludzie słali, a Polacy w Ameryce o muzeum pamiętali. Wincujemy wam na to 80 roków, szczęścia i zdrowia na każdym kroku, co byście tu w zgodzie zeli, a o Polski kto brak ucyli. Zeby mi się doczekali drugiego takiego święta, co byście byli zdrowi i weseli, jako w niebie anieli. Co by była boską opieka z nieba i nikomu nie zabrakło chleba. Tego wam i nam, syćkim zycom dzieci, rodzice i zarząd z Fundacji Kultury Taczeńskiej. Amen.
Pobłogosławił dzisiejszą uroczystość cieplejszą temperaturą. Kto się spodziewał? Prawie 50 stopni w styczniu. Proszę księdza Andrzeja Tockę, dyrektora Polskiej Misji Duszpasterskiej w Chicago, a zarówno proboszcza Kościoła Świętej Trójcy w Chicago, o błogosławienie za te ostatnie i następne 80 lat. The pastor of the Holy Trinity Polish Mission, Reverend Andrzej Tocke, will lead us in benediction.
Niech będzie pochwalony Jezus Chrystus. Powstańmy. Almighty God, we thank you for giving us the opportunity to celebrate this wonderful occasion of the 80th anniversary of the opening of the Polish Museum of America. At this special day, we give thanks for all of you who are here present and all those who have contributed to the life and success of this place throughout the 80 years history. Almighty Lord, as we mark and celebrate 80 years of service of this place, we also give thanks for those who have served the Polish-American community here. Today, as we celebrate this milestone, not only in the life of the Polish Museum of America, but of our entire Polish-American community in the United States, we ask your blessings on us, and we pray that also the future generations may learn to know and to love Polish culture. We ask the Our Lady of Częstochowa to keep us under her special protection so that we may prove ourselves worthy of God's continued blessings for many years to come. Hail Mary. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Dzięki Bożej opatrzności jesteśmy tutaj, aby celebrować 80. rocznicę powstania tej ważnej dla Polonii amerykańskiej placówki. I dzisiaj dziękujemy Bogu za to, że natchnął naszych poprzedników do działania, które zaowocowało utworzeniem tego bardzo ważnego miejsca na mapie Chicago. Dzisiaj wyrażać chcemy naszą wdzięczność wszystkim, którzy tworzyli i obecnie pracują w tym unikalnym miejscu, gdzie pielęgnuje się polską tradycję i polską kulturę. Pragnę w imieniu Polskiej Misji Duszpasterskiej na Trójcowie podziękować pracownikom muzeum za współpracę i wspieranie różnych inicjatyw. I dzisiaj też pamiętajmy o tych wszystkich, którzy już odeszli. Módlmy się za zmarłych, którzy oddali swój czas, swoje talenty dla nas, obecnie tutaj żyjących i korzystających z tego dzieła. Wierzymy, że to wielkie dziedzictwo Polonia będzie w stanie zachować dla przyszłych pokoleń. Dlatego wypraszajmy błogosławieństwa Bożego na kolejne lata istnienia Polskiego Muzeum i o to się módlmy wspólnie słowami modlitwy pańskiej. Ojcze nasz, któryś jest w niebie, święć się imię Twoje, przyjdź królestwo Twoje, bądź wola Twoja, jako w niebie, tak i na ziemi. Chleba naszego powszedniego daj nam dzisiaj i odpuść nam nasze winy, jako i my odpuszczamy naszym winowajcom. I nie wódź nas na pokuszenie, ale nas zbaw. A więc przyjmijmy Boże błogosławieństwo na te kolejne lata wspólnego działania dla dobra Polonii, Polonii amerykańskiej, Polski i Stanów Zjednoczonych. Pan z wami. I was błogosławi Bóg Wszechmogący, Ojciec i Syn i Duch Święty. Szczęść Boże.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we conclude, Marek and Agnieszka Kowalczyk have returned, hopefully with some sunshine from Cancun. We ask they please come up to receive their award.
We have good news that Marek and Agnieszka Kowalczyk have arrived, and so we would like to have them come forward to see, receive their certificate and a small rose as a thank you. Marek and Agnieszka? Yes. And the daughters. Here they come. A beautiful family coming forward. I would like to read the plaque. Life Member Recognition, the Polish Museum of America, presented to Marek and Agnieszka Kowalczyk, IDEA Furniture of Chicago, Illinois, for your contribution as a Legacy Life Member donor as of May 2016 to the Polish Museum of America. Your interests in and support of the oldest ethnic museum in America, where the past is preserved for the future, is greatly appreciated. Certified the 22nd day of January 2017, Richard Ofshani, President, Joseph A. Droba, Jr., Chairman of the Board. Let's give the Kowalczyks a big hand.
Thank you for celebrating 80 years of the Polish Museum of America with us today. Your part is not over, mine is.
We ask that you continue your support of the museum so generations of Americans, especially those of Polish ancestry, can experience the history and culture of our forefathers. Szanowni Państwo, dziękuję za przybycie na dzisiejszy jubileusz 80-lecia otwarcia Muzeum Polskiego w Ameryce. W imieniu zarządu serdecznie dziękuję za poparcie i prosimy o dalsze wsparcie tej instytucji dla przyszłych pokoleń. Życzę przyjemnego wieczoru, a teraz please enjoy the musical performance of vocalists Grażyna Aguścik, Mieczysław Szcześniak and pianist Jurek Jabłoński. As for me, thank you very much. You've been a wonderful audience. And I am honored to have been able to serve you. Thank you.
It's my pleasure to be here tonight celebrating 80th anniversary of Polish Museum in America. There was one summer, some years ago, I was working here during the weekend hours. So I have a very special mission. During the Christmas break, I was in Poland. I met a friend of mine, father, who was who is 93 years old. And he asked me to make a recording of a very important song. It's called Kolenda 10 Pawilonu Więzienia Mokotowskiego. He shared with me the story. He was a prisoner for 109 months, almost 10 years after Second World War, because he was a fighter, he was an underground party, Armia Krajowa. And so he had to stay in the prison for almost 10 years. And so they didn't have a chance to communicate. They couldn't whistle, they couldn't sing, but they were spreading the words, using the wall, just touching the wall, like alphabet Morse. How is called it? Alphabet Morse alphabet. And so then they were one of the prisoner, Jan Gołba, Gołka. He wrote the lyrics to the Kolenda, to the music of Maluśki. And they were singing this Kolenda every Christmas time. There was a very emotional time for them. They took a risk to sing the song and the Christmas carol. And for them, music, there was a very important part of their being there, their life, because they didn't have anything else. They were just staying silent, but from time to time, they were singing. They were punished after this, but they took a risk. So I'm gonna sing this Kolenda, first time in my life, and I promise him, so I will dedicate to this Kolenda to Stanisław Oleksiak, a 93 years old survivor.
Hej, Kolenda, Kolenda, Betlejem, Kolenda, jasna u nas nieba. Hej, Kolenda, Kolenda, Mokotów, Kolenda, kęs czarnego chleba. Między nas Pan Jezus wszedł, na więziennym stołku siadł. Między nas Pan Jezus wszedł i chleb czarny z nami. Na koszuli numer szył. Między nas Pan Jezus wszedł i w karterze z nami był. Hej, kolęda, kolęda, Betlejem, kolęda, 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 mokotów kolęda, o wolność wołanie. Między nas Pan Jezus wszedł, cichutko zapłakał. Między nas Pan Jezus wszedł, gdy bił Polak Polaka. Ej, kolęda, kolęda, mokotów kolęda, dzieciątko wstające. Ej, kolęda, kolęda, mokotów kolęda, z nadzieją i w męce. Między nas Pan Jezus wszedł, skinie rączką swą Bożą. Między nas Pan Jezus wszedł, wszystkie drzwi otworzą.
Fryderyk Chopin, etiuda bemol. Invite my dearest friend, the most talented singer, very famous for many, many years. What else I can tell? I don't know, it's just the most incredible person, Mieczysław Szcześniak. So we had a beautiful concert last night at the Holy Trinity Church. We were playing with the whole orchestra. But the orchestra left us. Some part of the orchestra left to LA, some part in different part of this town. And so Mietek has an orchestra in the box. So he's gonna play some of his beautiful tunes. And so please welcome Mietrzysław Szcześniak.
Ladies and gentlemen, panie i panowie, chciałbym się powiedzieć, że zasypani i zasypań panie, ale nie ma śniegu w Chicago, z czego ja się bardzo cieszę. Wczoraj mieliśmy prawie wiosnę. Czy państwo mnie rozumiecie? No. Zaśpiewam piosenkę, którą napisał Jacek Kaczmarski. Muzykę skomponował Zbigniew Łapiński. Napisali większą część, która nazywała się Szukamy Stajenki. Jak to poeta, dobry poeta, napisał od urodzenia aż do zakończenia. Prawie. Pięknie nazywa się ta całość Szukamy Stajenki, a ja zaśpiewam jedną z piosenek, którą nazwał poeta Scena to dziwna. Teraz zaśpiewam Państwu piosenkę, którą skomponował znany polski kompozytor piosenek Seweryn Krajewski. Śpiewałem ją na festiwalu Eurowizja, reprezentując Polskę w 1999 roku. Jest jak rozmowa z ojcem, jak modlitwa. Nazywa się Przytul mnie mocno. Nie wiem, kto dopisał tekst do naszych ról. Nie wiem, skąd w tych rolach błąd i żal i ból. Prowadź mnie do prostych słów przez każdy dzień. Prowadź mnie, gdy światło drży i gdy pada cień. Przytul mnie i połam lód w opłatki. Przytul mnie, nadejdzie znów wiosenny świt. Dopóki żal naprawia błąd, nadzieję mam. Dopóki łza jest jeszcze łzą, jeszcze łzą. Nie jestem sam. O nie, nie jestem sam. Dziękuję bardzo. Dziękuję. Mam jeszcze jedną piosenkę dla Państwa. Piosenkę, która jest tytułową piosenką mojej ostatniej płyty, ponieważ skomponowałem bosanowe i samby do wierszy księdza Twardowskiego, księdza Jana Twardowskiego. Bardzo miło. Jego piękne i mądre wiersze mają niezwykle lekką formę. Myślałem o tym, jaką formę nadać tej treści. Pomyślałem, że bossanowa i samba, brazylijska muzyka pogodna, pozytywna i lekka, rytmiczna, będzie najlepszą oprawą. Nie wiem, czy udało mi się. Tę płytę zadedykowałem mojej babce Zofii, która nauczyła mnie radości śpiewania i która z ulubieniem śpiewała przedwojenne piosenki, zachęcając mnie, żebym też je śpiewał. Nie pamiętam nawet od kiedy nauczyłem się z nią śpiewać na dwa głosy. Może miałem 3 lata, może 4. Więc babcia już patrzy z nieba na to wszystko, pewnie się uśmiecha. Chciałem, żeby jej się spodobało, może też spodobają się Państwu. Poeta mówi, że każdemu z nas czegoś brakuje, że jesteśmy nierówni. A nierówni potrzebują siebie. Zobaczcie Państwo, czy ta piosenka działa. Nierówni. wszyscy byli silni jak konie, gdyby wszyscy byli jednakowo bezbronni w miłości. Gdyby każdy miał to samo, gdyby każdy miał to samo, nikt nikomu nie byłby potrzebny. Co mam i to, czego nie mam, nawet to, czego nie mam komu dać, zawsze jest komuś potrzebne, nierówni potrzebują siebie. To, co mam i to, czego nie mam, nawet to, czego nie mam komu dać, zawsze jest komuś potrzebne, nierówni potrzebują siebie, nierówni potrzebują siebie. Jest noc, żeby był dzień, ciemność, żeby świeciła gwiazda. Jest ostatnie rozstanie i rozłąka pierwsza. Kochamy, bo innym serce wychłudło. Kochamy, bo innym serce wychłudło. List przybliża, bo inny oddala. Co mam i to, czego nie mam, nawet to, czego nie mam komu dać, zawsze jest komuś potrzebne, nierówni potrzebują siebie. To, co mam i to, czego nie mam, nawet to, czego nie mam komu dać, zawsze jest komuś potrzebne, nierówni potrzebują siebie, nierówni potrzebują siebie. To, co mam, to, czego nie mam, nawet to, czego nie mam komu dać, zawsze jest komuś potrzebne, nierówni potrzebują siebie, nierówni potrzebują siebie, nierówni potrzebują siebie.
Dziękuję Państwu bardzo. Dziękuję.
Jeżeli mogę, to dziękuję za nierównych, dziękuję za słowa, dziękuję za to, żeby być blisko. Od 20 lat słuchamy Pana czasami w tej sali. Mam wielką przyjemność, że stało się dzisiaj to na jubileuszu, ale serdecznie dziękujemy, że Pan z nami jest. Dziękujemy Grażynce. Proszę Państwa, najpiękniejszy głos w Polsce jest naszym głosem.
Before we finish our formal program, I'd like to really thank our mistress of ceremony, Misha Yaminsky. Fabulous, fabulous job in running the program, keeping us on time, and making sure that we had an enjoyable evening. The program's not over. We're going to take a break to serve dinner, which is off to the side here. And afterwards, we're going to have Kolędowanie, caroling, to close off the evening. Again, we want to wish everybody a thank you for coming out here today. And please enjoy Smacznego.
So, Virginia. Do we have the board members present? If you see the Julita, you'll be on the photo.
Virginia.
Virginia. Board members, PMA staff and volunteers, please join us. Proszę bardzo, Pani Lusiu. Join us for the photo. Uwaga. Klęczę u stóp pani Ady. Thank you so very much for this historic moment. Thank you.